Mobility, freedom of movement, these are all terms that are used a lot these days, and that's a good thing. But there seem to be two distinct camps as to the concept of mobility. There's joint-specific mobility, which is zeroing in on a joint itself, finding its many issues and trying to work them out, trying to give that joint freedom to move, permission to be a little better. This might require some giant latex product, or it might require some little guy like this to get into that tension and just free it up. The point being for that specific joint to increase its range of motion. It's good stuff and it's quite necessary. The other is global mobility, the process of moving the body through complete ranges of motion through multiple planes. Flow if you want, grace, mastery of movement. Global mobility without joint-specific release, or joint-specific mobility without the flow of the entire body, we don't have a complete picture. So we need a balance of both. Today we're going to talk about global mobility, flow. It's talked a lot about these days, but the freedom isn't necessarily given to you. And I want that. I want us each to have our own artistic creations, our own ability. I want us to think of movement as an empty canvas where we can do our own thing. Sure, you can follow other people's flows and ideas, but you know what? Take a little bit from here and here and here and paint your own picture. Create your own flow. So today we're going to look at one of our standard flows, something we do as a warm-up. All of my clients do this as a warm-up, and how you can make it your own. You can all make it your own. My clients make it their own as well. They've added things and taken away things and made it their own complete package. And that's what I want you to start doing. So by using this example, hopefully you can see where you can take it in new directions or create one of your own. Starts with a basic wide leg hip stretch, pushing this hip forward, opening up that joint. Hands down. Reach up. I'm pushing my hips back, hinging at the hips like you would on a swing or a deadlift or a squat, and then opening this joint up. And then I'll turn and drop that knee down. I'm gonna hold this foot. Common thing that people wanna do is roll the foot, so I'm gonna hold it. And I'll roll my hips around, do a little dance. Move the hips. Maybe drop down to an elbow. Move the hips. Here into a pigeon pose, opening the hip, not trying to arch my back, but I'm pushing my hips forward, squeezing my butt, opening up at the joint, trying to get my hip down to my heel as close as I can. Hitchhike back to drive that hip even further into the heel. Then comes the fun part, swoop around, into a plow, into a squat, back to a plow, back to the same pigeon. Then shoot back into a downward facing dog. Now from here, I like a good calf stretch. Sink those heels down. You notice I can't get my heels to the ground. I'm trying. And then I'll shoot up into a scorpion. I'm gonna make the scorpion kind of fun. Knee to chest, up, turn my hips as much as I can. As a bonus, I'll come through, shoot through, and reach in a bridge. Back, down. Couple more hips, or a couple more heels. Knee up, twist. Bring it through. Back up, forward. And I'm back to the beginning, where I do the other side. All we're doing is we're asking the question, where can I go from here? I happen to be in this position. What's next? Your body will tell you. Listen to it. It'll say, I want to go there. Or I want to go there. You will come up with your own little dance, your own little flow. Move the hips. Go forward. Go back. Make circles. You can even do the same thing here. Nothing wrong with dancing a little. There's no license on anybody's flows. You don't have to follow anybody's flow. Make up your own. Find what needs work. Find where you need to open more and let it open. Go for it. Find your place. Where can I go from here? More calves. Knee in, up, turn, through, back. You know the beauty of making your own flow? It's yours! You made it. It's your artistic license, your creativity. You can do whatever you want. Where can you go from here? Seriously, there are a million variations you can do from this. There are limitless variations you can do with this. You can come up with a whole host of other things to add to this, or just trash it entirely and make your own. That's fine. You have complete freedom. You do, really, truly, honest to God. You've got it up here, you've got it here. Move. Here's how we're gonna take what we just did and tweak it just a little bit. Add a little thing here and there. Make it a little more advanced, perhaps. Not for some people, but for some people, yeah, maybe. Remember, we're here, we're dancing, we're doing a little dance, maybe even down on the elbow, and then we go into our pigeon pose. Well, from the pigeon pose, I usually recommend taking that arm, the same arm as the knee, and hitchhiking backwards, which we did a second ago. There's other options to this, though. You can actually open this way, or you can grab the back leg if you want and reach out. There's a bunch of variations on that alone. But from there, we go into that plow. Bring that back leg around, swoop, ha, and then come forward into that squat. Remember that? What if we jump? Or what if we pistol squat? Woo! Jump. Two small variations have made it considerably harder, but a lot more fun, if you know what I'm saying. Or what about this? So, once again, we're here. We're gonna do the same pigeon into the plow. This time we're gonna come forward. Plow back. Forward onto our hands into a crow. Okay, that's kind of fun. You can come back if you want. Where can we go from here? Plow back. Come forward. Crow. Extend out. Or plow back. Come forward. Push up. You've got some more options to play with. What else? Remember that downward facing dog in that combo? We can do some stuff from there, right? Let's try it. From here, why don't we turn it into a Hindu push-up? Down, through, up, lift the hips, back. Then we can go into our scorpion. Or a dive bomber push-up. Down, through the same way, return the same path. Boom! Then go into your scorpion. Or, why don't we do something fun with the scorpion as well? Through, up, scorpion all the way over, boom, into a bridge, and back, so, through, up, back, down, wherever we want to go after that. For ultimate injury prevention, performance, and holistic wellness, you need both. We need the global mobility of all the joints working together the way they're supposed to through full ranges of motion, synergy within each and every joint, making the body move as a unit. Plus, we need to get into each individual joint and work out what's going on in there. One does not fix the other. They help each other. They work together, both joint-specific mobility and global joint mobility. Now, although we've given you some of the tools and some of the keys to come up with your own flow ideas, you're gonna have to research your body. It's a perpetual journey. Listen, the body's trying to tell you something. It's all about the relationship between you and your body, learning what it needs, listening to its needs. It'll tell you. Have some fun with it. Create your own movement journey. Learn what each joint does and then build upon that. Keep growing it all the time, creating something new. The power is in your hands and feet and other limbs.